I've scratched my head about this. If I had that money, I think I could engage with Khabib. No, thank you. I'm good.
And he wants to get right back in.
And I'm like,
fight Floyd.
Definitely the Khabib one.
That's the top of the fire.
You know,
if you had to guess what's next, what would you think?
I won't pretend to understand the business side of things. Him and Audi and Paradigm, they do all of that, and you know the fans, and the officials decide, and who gets the next shot. I only deal with what's going to be put in front of me. I think it will be the rematch. I think it will be that. Now, I'll be getting torn apart on Twitter. It isn't there. This and this guy's. I'm only saying what I think. But is it going to be someone else? Will it be? You know, is Tony going? I don't really know, but. That's what I see him talking about, so that's how my mind is.
What do you think will be different in terms of the way he approaches it, in terms of like trash talking and all that other stuff?
He's never going to not be him. That's the side of his personality, you know. And you know, it's a dividing line. And my parents are not mad about it, but kids in my gym love it. You know, it's just one of those things. Conor's never not going to do that. That's. Like in Dublin, you know, where he's from, there was always that guy in the class that was just sharp wit, you know, had the quick reply. And from the moment I met him, he was just that guy that's like, fuck. You can't make a tiny mistake around him. You make you feel stupid very quick, you know, being on the end of it. But I remember that guy in school as well. And it just happens that he has a lethal left hand on top of that.
Yeah.
And then he has the look and he's just an unusual package that it all came together. So. I don't, you know, the build up for Diaz too. He didn't stop. It wasn't like he was going, oh, well, I hope I don't lose this time. And, you know, he went in with the same kind of mindset he had. And I've no doubt he would go into that fight as fully prepared as we can. And he'd be 100% sure in his mind he's going to destroy him in a round because that's how he always thinks.
If there's another fight that would sell and it would be huge, it would be that. It would be Diaz 3.
Oh, yeah.
That could be, especially if Diaz gets past Poirier.
Yes.
Even if he doesn't, I mean, just that fight alone. I mean, there's the history between those two guys. Mm-hmm. I mean, that would be.
And it's so appealing stylistically as well. The fight, you know, like I'm a grappler at heart. I love grappling, but I also understand that a jiu-jitsu tournament will put people to sleep. You know, even if you're into jiu-jitsu, it's hard to watch a jiu-jitsu tournament.
Yes.
But anybody can see a punch hitting someone in the head and then falling down. That's exciting. And him and Diaz, it's such a great personality matchup. It's such a great skill clash. You know, if I was to design somebody that's going to bring the best out of a corner, you'd want someone that, you know, can hit back and take a big shot and put up at the trash. It's a beautiful fight. I would love to see that rematch.
Yeah, the thing about Diaz when they first fought was that he didn't give a fuck about trash talk. It didn't bother him at all. It was normal.
Yes.
It was like, oh, okay, we're doing this.
Yeah, it was brilliant.
It was amazing. It was what everybody wanted to see at the time. It's because Conor was so good at talking shit and people would get so flustered. But then Diaz didn't give a fuck. And you could tell he didn't give a fuck. It was just so normal for him. And it was like, wow, trash talk doesn't work on Diaz.
Yeah.
It really doesn't work.
Yeah, like I'd known about some of his training partners and he's like Conor, like in the gym. He's trash talking his brother. Yeah. He's trash talking whoever he's sparring. It's because it's fun, you know. And it's always just, you know, when we have Conor having a big spar, you know, the gym will be packed down. Everybody wants to come down and see him spar.
Yeah.
And you see, you know, he's talking to the guy the whole way through, whether it's a close friend like Artem or whether it's someone we brought in that he doesn't know. It's not going to change him, you know. I certainly don't spar him, but I'll roll him and he'll trash talk me when I'm trying to do my jiu-jitsu. Shut up, Ilian. But it's his personality.
So what timeline do you think we're looking at in terms of his return, if you had a guess?
It was funny. I was looking at March 16th. Paddy's Day is March 17th. That's a Sunday. March 16th is a Saturday.
Oh, wow.
Imagine like MSG on the Saturday night before Paddy's Day.
Oh, my God.
That'd be insane.
I wonder if it's not booked.
Yeah, I was actually going to go on.
MSG's booked pretty far in advance.
I'd imagine so.
And they're doing one in November. To do two at MSG in a year.
I think you could do Conor in there every weekend.
You could also do the
just
Boston
him and Diaz
Garden.
Every weekend, and it's going to be packed out.
You could do the TD Garden in Boston, too.
Yeah, we've had good times there.
A lot of fucking Irish in Boston.
Yeah. More Irish in Boston than there is in Ireland.
And you could do, of course, Vegas anytime.
Vegas anytime. Yeah. But just I saw that date, but... you know, like you said, just the big summer card as well. You have the fight week, the July card. I think probably next summer is probably realistic. You know, we have to obviously see what punishment Habib gets. You know, I hope it's not a long ban.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Everybody was so amped up after the fact, and I was like, oh man, this could be terrible. But Monday morning, I'm like, what the fuck happened, really? Nobody died. Nobody even got cut. A couple people got punched in a place where people get punched. You know what I mean? It's like...
Yeah. I have the other hat in that. I have a big commercial gym. I coach kids. I'm head president of the Amateur MMA Association back home. I deal with politicians all the time. And this is the exact thing that they're arguing with me, or, you know, when I'm wearing a suit on a Wednesday meeting with the Minister for Sport. And so I'm looking at it going, great, that's what's going to be brought up at my next meeting when I'm trying to get governing body status for my life's work, my art, my sport.
Right.
And I'm trying to tell plus 60-year-olds that this is legitimate, and they're showing me this, and you're, you know, so for that, it was terrible, you know, there's no other way around.